This is the Ghetto Free Press, KYRC, Know Your Rights campaign, here in Valdosta, Lowndes County, the state of Georgia, and around the world. Know Your Rights campaign. Listen and listen well. But there are some people.
Because I tell the truth, not like the Valdosta Daily Times. I am not like your TV station. I am not like your radio station. I am a servant of the real Jesus Christ. And the real Buddha, if anything good is in them. And so you can come after me. But in the end, I will win. Because God decreed heaven and earth would pass away. But my word. So come on after me and then I want you to watch where man leads off and where God takes over. This ain't about me. Don't y'all know that? It's about the suffering people that have been suffering so long here in Brooks County and Lowndes County. And nothing is being done about it. So our children are filling the jails, filling the prisons, filling the probation rows, filling death row. And many of them are just like, they didn't do nothing wrong. I didn't do nothing wrong. I've been crying out to the world. I've been crying out to Al Sharpton. I haven't seen an Al Sharpton. I've been calling out to Jesse Jackson. I ain't seen no Jesse Jackson. I've been calling out to the United States Armed Forces as a United States veteran. Ain't nobody said nothing about my constitutional rights being trampled upon. Not in Russia, not in China, but in the United States of America. And so we better wake up. We better wake up, y'all. We better wake up. We had better wake up. When law enforcement take an innocent man and take an honest, righteous man, it's ban him. Any reason at all, ban my freedom of movement. Well, hell, that's what they did under slavery. That's what they did under Jim Crow. And now they're doing it in 2013. So we must ask ourselves a question in truth. How many black boys are now in jail? How many are on probation? How many are on death row? Because of lies by law enforcement. If they could do it to me, then they could do it to you. They can do it to your children. And I believe, based upon the precedent that have been set with me, they are planning it for your children to come. And so you Negroes, you white wrong people, you white right people, you Jews, Germans, Christians, Muslims, and those in the Arab world who got relatives in the United States, they could just be traveling back home. Put handcuffs on you, they'll take you to the Lowndes County Jail. And although nobody's talking about it but me, 31 people have died for whatever reason in the Valdosta and Lowndes County Jail. Mayor Freddie didn't address the issue. Mayor Gale is not addressing the issue. The chairman of the Lowndes County Board of Commissioners and all elected officials in our community is not saying anything. And from 2009 to 2013 is like top secret in the land of the free and the home of the brave. We would expect that when we learn in civic lessons that something like that would be criminal in some communist nation or in Iran or in Palestine. But I'm not talking about any of those places. I'm talking about here in the United States of America. About freedom and justice for foreigners while our own rights are going to hell. I'm gonna close this hand, haven't been told. And this is why I do not believe Dr. Dennard, listen. This is why Dr. Dennard and the Quitman 10 plus 2 over in Brooks County, that District Attorney David Miller and others, the GBI, arrested for alleged voter fraud. We are getting ready to go into the third year. They have not gone to trial. And I do not believe, I say it with emphasis, I do not believe that the Quitman 10 plus 2 can receive a fair trial in the Southern judiciary and not even in the state of Georgia. If they're gonna go to court, they got to go outside of the state of Georgia, because I said it before, and they approved it every day, that Georgia, the state of Georgia, the people state, got their own set of laws, and they only respect the law that they want, and disregard others when they want to. Now, this is hard for you. All I'm asking anybody to do, I'm challenging the governor of the state of Georgia. Call CNN. Get me on the podium behind the mic with you. And let's debate the issues. Let me go back to my blog, kvci.blogspot.com. And let me show you something. Let me show you of the news worthy incidents that have been ignored by the South Georgia press. This is why they put a prison across the land of Florida over the Brooklyn County Board of Elections, July 17th, 2020. A meeting concerning voting irregularities. Ryan D. Kiff, Secretary of State, sent Glenn Austin from Macon, Georgia, down to investigate. But they never responded back to the voters in Brooks County. And so we have the record. We have the record. We have the names of the 31 jail deaths. We have the names of the week of terror when 15 to 25 blacks were murdered in Quitman. We got the record of Earl Evans shot, burned up in a police car in Quitman, and he was a law enforcement officer. We got the record of the Wooten. Once again, could this story could have been the reason why they put me on a criminal trespass warning here in Valdosta, Downs County, Georgia, following the death of Kendrick Johnson. Once again, I am George Boster Rhymes, and this is the Ghetto Free Press, doing what we do because it must be done. This is American Ghetto Free Press, August the 8th, 2013. I'm standing in front of Office Max. I just spent some dollars there, and I come here quite frequently, but I'm to the point now here in Valdosta, Georgia. Too often I go into businesses and I don't see blacks employed. Now, I counted the number of workers there. I'm not gonna give them now, but I didn't see any black employees. Yet when I walk through the South Side, I see all these black people sitting on their porches and saying, they put in applications in various businesses and they are not employed. Well, maybe it's that they are not qualified. Well, we know that some people may not be qualified, but there's also maybe a need to get them qualified. So when we go into these stores to spend our black economic dollars, that we will see somebody that looks like us. How do our children feel when they go to retail stores, hardware stores, and restaurants, and in the restaurants don't see any blacks employed? It is time now for us to learn from the George Zimmerman not guilty verdict that came from a no black jury. That should be an inspiration to all of us to make a difference. Don't protest, don't get mad, just spend your dollars where you see somebody that looks like you. Moreover, it's time for black people to create businesses like the Korean, Japanese, whites, and others so we can employ the white unemployed. After all, this is the land of the free and the home of the brave. This is American Ghetto Free Press. I repeat, the Ghetto Free Press, KYRC, which means Know Your Rights campaign. You have a right not to spend your dollars where that you are not employed. You have a right, that is your right, under the Constitution of the United States of America. And we are looking for our pastors to get up out of the gutters, to get up out of the ditch, to get up and stand up for your congregation and stop letting your congregation members come to Reverend Rose and others to do the fighting that the pastors used to do. But it seemed like those days are long gone. Once again,
George Foster rhymes in the streets of Valdosta, Georgia, on America's Ghetto Free Press, giving you the truth, because too often the truth is ignored, pushed to the back burner, or not seen at all. Peace be unto you. Bye-bye, we gone. Remember, Know Your Rights campaign. Why buy to places that don't hire people that look like you? When our children are filling the jails and prisons in disproportionate numbers. Bye-bye, we're gone.